go for 6 hours in the dugout, and then play a baseball game. Yeah, it was a good experience. It was a lot of fun. I know I had a good time. I think the kids did too. I'm proud of these guys. These guys are a class act from, you know, each and every one. The way that they've gone about their business all year, the highs were high and the lows were still pretty high. We didn't let the losses affect us. We worked hard to get better. And you know, it's really a testament to these guys and how hard they worked from March 12th until June 16th. You know, with the bad spring that we had, the time that we spent as a gym trying to play catch for a game that you throw a ball sometimes close to 200 or 300 feet, it was a challenge. But I know I told these guys multiple times, I told parents, I told the coaches, I never heard a complaint. And to me, that's a testament to their dedication to the sport and their dedication to getting better each and every day. And they did a wonderful job. You know, some big games over the last few weeks, just to recap. You know, I was sitting on the bus on the way home and it's like, holy, you know, first, we got past the first round. you know, I don't know if the kids felt the same way or not, but that was a huge, huge win, I think, for their confidence. You know, BLH wasn't a scrap. They're not a bad team. You know, and so to get that W that day, I think a lot of them, at least myself included, felt that weight lifted. And then it was, let's go have fun. You know, we turned around and we went back to Springfield, beat them handedly, and we owed them, not only for the week before, but, you know, the last couple of years. You know, that was a huge springboard in the momentum. And then we went to Cathedral, okay? And I don't know, I think somebody pitched that game. Let's see, what was it? Was it Ricky? Did he pitch that game? Let's see. You know, throws a no-hitter. I mean, who the fuck? Not that he's not capable of it, but, you know, throw a no-hitter against Nome Cathedral. I thought I heard in the paper that Wire said that was the first time he had ever been no-hit. Wire has 500-400 wins, okay? You know, so he's been around the block. And so for us to do it, for that kid down there to do it, that was huge. I don't think I've ever got such a big hug from a kid after that game until later. But that was big. Then obviously the two games with Bowl. You know, that Saturday game, Hirschbeck and I were talking to the other coaches. I think they thought, see, you got 7 seed. We're going to show up. We'll walk out of here. And sorry, boys, but we're for real. Okay? And I think that really gave us confidence going into that next game when we basically did the same thing. You know, so for these guys to go from an underrated 7 seed to win in the section championship was a very I can do the playoffs. not a bad news performance from Avery. You know, well deserved in the way he threw all year. You know, it's no surprise. You know, he went about, attacked the strike zone, and did a one heck of a job. Kip Kovar, who took care of doing the media stuff for us again. I think he tweeted or something and said it was the 13th no-hitter in state tournament history. That's a pretty cool company to be in. Okay, and that's a big check mark on Avery's resume. He did a nice job. FYI,
the season with 105 strikeouts in 60 2/3 innings. Okay, that's dominating. That's flat out impressive. Then Bergie said, "Well, I'll try to outdo you," and he goes out. Was it yesterday? Goes out yesterday and no.
Ellie,
please silence your phones. He goes out yesterday and gets up his first run. I think it was in three outings. I forget the number of innings that he had in between where it was shutout innings. In FYI on him, he gave up four runs to earn all year. Okay, I think his ERA was 0.44 at the end of the year. Okay, that's good, Jacob. You know, and today, you know, I told the kids, I said earlier, we had to sit there for 6 hours in the dugout before we got to play at Target Field, and then we got to play on that field. And again, not the outcome that we probably wanted, but I'll take second place any day of the week. You know, and again, the guys battled. I was proud of how they kept their composure. I was proud of how they represented themselves through all the game today. And again, I think it goes back to being a class act and having, you know, having a good sense of themselves. Few other things before I move on to thanking people. There's lots of individual accomplishments this season. One that will be coming up this next weekend, Friday and Saturday. Both Avery and Carter got selected to be in a play ball all-star game. They play in Chaska Friday and Saturday. One game Friday, and they'll play two games on Saturday. In my tenure as head coach, they're number three and number four. I'm not sure we've ever had two kids in the same class make that all-star game. So, you know, give them a round of applause for that. It's in Shasta, it's the same place, so I'm kind of expecting Avery to go out and do the same thing, and I'm kind of expecting Carter to go out and do the same thing, so no pressure, guys. And as I said, you know, I could go on and on and on about individual accomplishments, but it really comes down to a team. It comes down to these 15 guys and these four coaches and these three stat girls, even though one's sitting up there. You know, it comes down to, I'm proud to say that I've coached these kids. You know, you've represented yourself, the team, the school, and the community of Sleepy Eye very, very well. And so, again, I want to thank you guys. Next, I'd like to thank the parents. Okay? The reason why these kids are the way they are is because of you and the roles that you've played in their lives and the things that how you've raised them. Yes, Chad, I'm still looking. You're included in that. You know, it definitely makes coaching these guys a lot easier. Okay? It makes it fun when you don't have to worry about shenanigans. You know, take these guys up to a hotel for 3 days. I'll say this, but I don't really mean it. I would take them up there for 3 days again in a heartbeat. Side story, yeah. We'll pass your kids one who's needed. But again, thank you, parents, for raising these fine young men and a few young ladies. Next, I'd like to thank the coaching staff. Corey for doing an amazing job of everything, all the behind-the-scenes stuff that nobody ever sees or knows that he does. You know, and that's not even including the coaching part of it.
you know, the little things here and there that, that he has to do from the AD role, and then turn around and you know, start coaching. Thank you for everything. You know, and I think he deserves a round of applause for it. I'd like to thank Brandon for the great job that he's done at the JV level over the last few years and the junior high before that. You know, helping these kids build the skills that they need so that when I get them at the varsity level, they're ready for varsity ball. So Brandon, we're hi, all right. Thank you. And then last of all, I'd like to thank John Hirschenbecker. Something like that. And, you know, thank you for being there, for volunteering all your countless hours. You know, he's been there from the beginning as my tenure as head coach. He won't believe this, but I've learned a lot from you, and I appreciate it. And I mean that in all sincerity. You know, John in his younger days. He's calmed down a lot. We'll just put it down. But just the baseball knowledge that he brings to the dugout is phenomenal. He knows how to keep the kids loose. On the bus, in the dugout, in the hotel. You know, I think every time I saw him in the hallway, he'd tell me, "This is great. I'm having so much fun." But thank you for being there and helping with this, and I greatly appreciate it. Lastly, I'd like to thank my wife and girls. Thank you for supporting me here this spring. thanks to Jackie for being a single parent. Her practice is done, the games are over. She gets to listen to me complain, boot, holler, whatever it is, so thank you for that. Thanks to my girls for being who they are and understanding that I can't make it to all their stuff because I'm hanging out with these yahoos. So I thank you for that, and I appreciate it. Thank you to all you guys who have come and support these kids throughout not only this year, but years in the past, being there for them, encouraging them, keeping them out of trouble, but mostly the support that they give, that you give them, is huge. We got a freaking second place. It's gonna be really sad. One last thing I'll turn it over to Corey. You know, when we were practicing for 4.5 years in the gym this spring, they kept looking up at the banners, and they kept looking up there, going, "We want to change that banner over on the left by the speaker." And they kept changing, they kept looking at it. Then Monday this week, we weren't able to get outside and practice in here. Took some hit in the cage. And it was really fun to watch the kids walk in here, and they looked up there and went, "Conference, okay, we're gonna have to change that." Some of them went, "What's a subsection?" That doesn't matter. But section, check. State tournament, check. Okay, that's a lot of fun. Hey, that's a lot of fun, so I don't know who's in charge of fixing those banners, Corey, but I'd like it done by Friday. So, again, thank you guys. Thank you, players, staff, girls, families, and the school and the community of Sleepy Nights. Okay, thank you.
But it took a while to build things up, and those kids that were part of that, you know, they paved the way for these guys here. So I'd like to say a few things. I'd like to personally thank the seniors. It's been a lot of fun. I've had the the privilege to coach these kids since, well, Zach has been, I've been fortunate enough to coach him since he's about 6 years old. And then I latched on with some of the other guys. I'd like to thank, there's some coaches out here from Leavenworth to Sleepy Eye to Stark to Sleepy Eye Blaze. The whole intention with those was to get these guys to where they're at now. And it paid off. So you got Dean Brinkman out there, Jason Stevens, Chad Berg, John Noki. I know Brandon coached them some there when they were younger as well. There's some other people out here too. So let's give them a round of applause. They have a hand in this. And all those trips to, you know, the cities and tournaments and all the extra money that was spent along the way. And I think these seniors would probably agree it was worth it. And most importantly, they turned out to be great men. And today isn't the defining moment in your life, but I know because you guys have been part of CGI baseball, you're going to do great in life. And that's what's most important. So congratulations to you guys. You're well deserved. Thank you. Any seniors?
Extremely young, like Coach Sean and my dad said. Thank you to all the coaches who have had us throughout the years and all the parents that have supported us along the way. It really means a lot to us. Especially shout out to all the fans that have followed us throughout this year as I looked through the stands. Most of you have been at most of the games all year, so I mean, thank you for sticking with us this whole time. We really appreciate it. This group of seniors has been awesome, and I know we're on the bigger things in life, but we'll always have a special place for me. So, anyways.